One should never take sides in anything, Mr. Kevill. Taking sides is the beginning of sincerity, and earnestness follows shortly afterwards, and the human being becomes a bore. However, the House of Commons really does very little harm. You can't make people good by act of Parliament. That's something.
You cannot deny that the House of Commons has always shown great sympathy with the sufferings of the poor.
That is its special vice. That is the special vice of the age. One should sympathize with the joy, the beauty, the colour of life. The less said about life's sores, the better, Mr. Kevill.
I am not at all in favour of amusements for the poor. Blankets and coals are sufficient. There is too much love of pleasure amongst the upper classes as it is. Health is what we want in modern life. The tone is not healthy. Not healthy at all.
You are quite right, Lady Caroline.
I believe I am usually right.
Horrid word, health.
Silliest word in our English language. And one knows so well the popular idea of health. The English country gentleman galloping after a fox. The unspeakable in full pursuit of the uneatable.
What are you saying, Lord Illingworth?
Oh, I was merely talking to Mrs. Allenby about the leading articles in the London newspapers.
But do you believe all that is written in the newspapers?
I do. Nowadays, it is only the unreadable that occurs.
Are you going, Mrs. Allenby?
Oh, just as far as the conservatory. Lord Illingworth told me this morning that there was an orchid there as beautiful as the seven deadly sins.
My dear, I hope there is nothing of the kind. I will certainly speak to the gardener.
Lord Illingworth, will you accompany me?
I shall be delighted, Mrs. Allenby.
Remarkable type, Mrs. Allenby.
She lets her clever tongue run away with her sometimes.
Is that the only thing, Jane, Mrs. Allenby allows to run away with her?
I hope so, Caroline, I'm sure.
You believe good of everyone, Jane. It is a great fault.
Do you really, really think, Lady Caroline, that one should believe evil of everyone?
I think it is much safer to do so, Lady Stutfield. Until, of course, people are found out to be good. But that requires a great deal of investigation nowadays.
But there is so much unkind scandal in modern life.
Lord Illingworth remarked to me last night at dinner that the basis of every scandal is an absolutely immoral certainty.
Lord Illingworth is, of course, a very brilliant man, but he seems to me to be lacking in that fine faith in the nobility and purity of life, which is so important in this century.
Yes, quite important, is it not?
He gives me the impression of a man who does not appreciate the beauty of our English home life. I would say that he was tainted with foreign ideas on the subject.
There is nothing like the beauty of home life, is there?
It is the mainstay of our moral system in England, Lady Stutfield. Without it, we would become like our neighbours.
That would be so, so sad, wouldn't it?
And I am afraid, too, that Lord Illingworth regards woman simply as a toy. Now, I have never regarded woman as a toy. Woman is the intellectual helpmeet of man in public as in private life. Without her, we should forget the true ideals, Lady Stutfield.
I am so very, very glad to hear you say that.
You a married man, Mr. Kettle?
Kevill, my love, Kevill.
I am married, Lady Caroline.
Family?
Yes.
How many children?
Eight.
Mrs. Kettle and the children are, I suppose, at the seaside.
My wife is at the seaside with the children, Lady Caroline.
You will join them later on, no doubt.
If my public engagements permit me.
Your public life must be a great source of gratification to Mrs. Kettle.
Kevill, Kevill, my love, Kevill.